waste matters because in Massachusetts it's predicted that our landfills are going to be full within 9 years' time. Luckily, Massachusetts put out a food waste ban for institutions to try to limit that amount of food waste that is going to our landfills.
UMass leads the industry, or at least is tops in the industry as far as our sustainability is concerned, and we have a huge reputation to uphold. We have to be excellent from the top down in everything that we do.
In general, in our operations, I like to follow the EPA's food waste pyramid. So at the very top, the first priority of that food pyramid is waste reduction strategies. How do we prevent it creating this excess waste at all?
Clean Path is all over the country, and we've been using it here for, I'd say, over 5 years now. And we just updated our system where it's taking pictures of the food. So this is really adding to our story. We can see what's being wasted, we can see what's being composted visually, but also see in pounds. So, you know, for instance, what does a whole bin of romaine cores look like? Can we be using those cores?
The past 3 years, we've reduced our waste to the financial amount of around $750,000.
The culinary staff works very closely with, you know, watching how vegetables and even proteins are trimmed. We don't want to be wasting any of that, and so looking at if something even needs to be peeled and trimmed. Sometimes the skin is very nutrient rich and we want to use that. So now vegetables are, you know, peeled or trimmed differently than years ago.
Reducing your food cost by 10%, 5%, any of that neighborhood, that money is free money now. That's 5-10% of your budget you can throw right back into the local economy without adding a penny to your overall costing.
When any of the prep is being done, the trim is sitting right there in front of either the person doing it or it's visible to the customer. They see what we're doing here every day. So that definitely starts our mind spinning, seeing the heaping mounds of food that potentially is now going into the compost. So A, is it edible? Will it make something taste good? Can it enhance the flavor? Can we make a stock from it or a soup base? Where then we wouldn't have to order that. We could be doing that in-house. So those are all things that we definitely look at prior to putting it in the compost bin. Having more stations that provide just-in-time cooking, so there wasn't more overproduction or food that was wasted because it wasn't being consumed. So cooking just-in-time, or also stations that didn't actually cook the food, like our stir-fry station, until the customer requested it to be cooked. So that cut down drastically on any overproduction or food waste that would have been composted.
You have a philosophy here of what we call small plate, big flavor. Basically what that means is that we're serving you correct portion sizes. As you look around our dining commons, you're not going to see a tray as well, so we're a trayless environment. What the effect of that was about a 30% reduction of food waste.
We take the further initiative of educating our customers, so serving less, which is our part, serving smaller portions every day, and then educating the students on reducing their waste on the plate, so only taking what they will consume at each sitting.
The second part of that EPA pyramid, the second priority under reducing the amount of waste that we're creating, is feeding people.
And the reality of it is, when you look at students at colleges, you start to say, you know, 1 in 6 is food insecure, yet, you know, an average American's throwing away 40% of their food, the numbers don't add up.
It is really great edible food you don't want to see end up in the compost stream. So we donate that food to Craig stores in Amherst. And so we're doing this through the Food Recovery Network, which is a national program. Beneath feeding people, there is composting down at the bottom. And composting sort of just a step up from the landfill, but there's all these other steps that we want to consider before even composting, because composting is great, but it's not enough.
We've had a composting program for over 10 years here at UMass. In general, we're doing about 1,200 tons of food waste, compostable waste a year. And, you know, that's a lot. And then you start to vision it, that's 25 city buses filled to the top, end to end, of food waste.
we were very moving forward with not increasing more waste, even though we were increasing our customer base.
It's really my job to help on that education piece of the student body, so I do that as much as possible through passive signage. Because students don't necessarily go to the dining commons to learn. It's where they take a break from learning and where they have this family feel and where they ground themselves and nourish themselves and give themselves energy to go back out and learn. But that doesn't mean that there isn't a great opportunity for passive education through really amazing and interesting signage and displays. So you'll see that in all of our operations through posters, through screens, through even beautiful, simple things like vegetable displays or flower displays that can be educational and engage people in the process. Anything that can boost your staff's morale and train them at the same time is really powerful. So it's not just do this because we're telling you to do this, but do this because it's the right thing. Do this because you're helping us in this larger sense. And that feeling boosts morale. Sustainability is a great story for that. You know, it's something to be a part of, truly, and we're trying to weave it into the value system here.